Database recovery with long-running transactions has been a challenge. And in SQL Server 2019, we introduced accelerated database recovery to help solve that problem. And Kevin is here to tell us all about it today on Data Exposed. Hi, and welcome to another episode of Data Exposed. I'm your host, Jeroen, and today we have Kevin with us to talk about accelerated database recovery. So welcome, Kevin, to the show.
Thank you.
So accelerated database recovery. So what is it?
So it's an interesting feature. We'll call it ADR for short.
Okay, sure.
It came from looking at some of the pain points that customers have had running databases and keeping them highly available.
Mm-hmm.
And part of it has to do with the time it takes to bring a database online.
Right.
There's a number of phases that a database has to come through. And if you've got a long-running transaction, it can take a long time to clean that up. And mm-hmm. that leads to unavailability when it's doing that processing.
Right. So we know that that restoring is a pain point, right? That bringing it back is
right.
something that DBAs, well, kind of worry about.
Right. So the team looked at that whole process and thought, how can we reimagine it?
Mm-hmm.
So they've come out with ADR. It's based on a version store, so all the changes are versioned in the database. That lives in the file group of your choosing.
Okay.
And leveraging that, we can make the recovery process much quicker.
Cool.
I have some
Oh yeah. Let's switch
slides
to the slides.
That kind
sure.
of demonstrate. So here we have the classic recovery process. So it
mm-hmm.
starts, phase one is analysis. So you have to look through all the transactions in the log from the last checkpoint forward.
Yep.
And redo is any data changes that haven't been persisted in the data files have to be redone from the transaction log
uh-huh.
all the way through from the beginning of the oldest uncommitted transaction. So that's where the long-running transactions really hurt you.
Right, exactly.
It can take minutes to an hour or
yep.
more sometimes.
Yep.
And then phase three is undo, where you undo any transactions that weren't committed before the time you're rolling
right.
forward to. At the time the redo finishes, the database is partially available. And what that means is you can access the database, but any data that was under lock
mm-hmm.
from the original transactions will be under lock now. So even though there's nobody doing them, you can't access that data until undo completes.
Okay, so basically this is a long-running process, and then only after we arrive at phase three, I can start doing everything I want with the database again, right?
Right, right.
So okay, so tell me what
ADR does.
That's
how it works today. And along the bottom you see just the log record with different events in the log record.
Sure.
ADR changes that a lot.
Mm-hmm.
We have the persistent version store. You'll see it referenced as PVS.
Okay.
When we put that out in the previews, the PVS lived in the primary file group. And there's no ability to change that. So that happened. That's where all those versions lived. We got feedback that customers would like to be able to specify which file group that lives in. If
okay.
they've got a bulk file group or a very fast file group, whatever. So now you're with the release candidate and with the GA version when it comes out, you'll be able to specify which file group
okay.
and change it. There's a process for changing it as well.
Okay, cool.
But let's go through what the recovery process looks like with ADR.
Mm-hmm.
So it starts with analysis. That is unchanged from what you had before.
It's the same behavior, right?
Right.
Okay.
We've introduced a concept of an S-log. An S-log is an in-memory log that records only those system transactions that can't be versioned. So
okay.
most data versions you can change before and after
mm-hmm.
pictures of the data. So some schema changes, some things like that can't be versioned.
Sure.
So those get recorded in the S-log. So the idea is that it's a very few
right.
significant.
There will be a small set of
right.
transactions, right? Okay.
Mm-hmm. So part of the analysis and redo phase is recreating those in-memory logs from the transaction log records.
Mm-hmm.
So redo from the S-log is just leveraging the version store, because you've got before and after versions of all those rows, so it's very quick, and then you redo from the log
right.
just from the last checkpoint forward.
Mm-hmm.
At that point, your database is fully available.
Okay.
And you can undo is just reverting the versions,
yeah.
so you just point to the previous version instead of the current version. You don't have to physically undo the transaction and reverse.
So this is going to be way faster than the the older one normally?
Oh, way faster. We had a customer in the lab within the last couple of weeks that did some testing with ADR,
mm-hmm.
and they had a very active update workload, and they had a long-running transaction with it. They did this and did a rollback of that long-running transaction.
Right.
Without ADR, it took about a minute and a half to do that.
Which is, you know, still not too bad, but okay, warm.
Yeah, in their business, it makes a big difference.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. So then they retried that same scenario with ADR,
yeah.
and the time it took to do that recovery
uh-huh.
was 0 seconds. They couldn't measure it. It was so fast.
Oh, that's impressive.
So I mean, for them, yeah. I mean, they're back on the line that much faster,
right.
which makes a big difference too, because in their business, any outage is a loss in revenue.
Right. So milliseconds count, right?
Very much so.
Okay. So if we can help this customer move from like 1.5 minutes, you said, to basically zero, that's impressive.
That's pretty huge.
Okay. So, wow. So all of our customers are probably wanting to try this and enable this. So can you tell me how I do that? I have a database now. I have it on the normal recovery.
Right.
So what do I do?
So with Azure SQL Database, it's on by default globally.
Okay.
It's been on by default globally for months.
So you don't need to do anything there.
Yep. You've already taken advantage of it.
Cool.
For SQL Server databases, it's off by default because there is some overhead. It's on the range of 1 to 5% for keeping track of the versions.
Mm-hmm.
So you'd have to turn it on, and that's just alter database set accelerated database recovery equals on. And optionally, with file group equals
something.
Yeah. So mm-hmm. very simple DDL.
Okay. And then what happens?
And then it starts tracking versions, and you get the benefit.
Cool. And is that direct, immediate, or is that
yes.
like there's a restart required?
No or restart required. Nothing? You just online.
Cool. So wow. So basically, this is like a very cool technology to restore your database very quickly.
Yeah.
Anything else that I get from this? I mean, this is really very impressive, but these are like extra benefits.
So there's an extra benefit in that because of the way we reuse the versions, we don't have to keep as much transaction log online. So you can truncate the transaction log much more aggressively
mm-hmm.
up to the last checkpoint
right.
than you could before, which means if you've got a situation where you have a long-running transaction that's keeping you from being able to truncate your log and the transaction log starts blowing up, that doesn't happen with ADR turned on.
Okay, so basically that's the extra benefit.
Right.
No long transaction log dragging along
exactly.
with us. Cool, I know what I will do. I mean, my SQL Server will go to accelerated database recovery right now.
Yeah.
After this video, I'll do that. Thanks a lot for sharing.
Thank you.
Thanks for explaining. This was very clear. And thank you for watching. Please like and subscribe and stay tuned for the next. Thanks.